Sam, can you tell us a little about these very colourful huts that we see just behind us all along the beach area here?
The sheds, oh, they belong to the Fishermans Tale, yeah. And well, as far as I know, the Fishermans Tale owns this place down here, like the harbour board thinks they own the place, like, you know, but they don't own it at all. This place was built for from the what you call it, call them. The Quakers built this place, like, and it was always for the fishermen, don't, and they built it for fishermen, like, and the people of Cobh. And while the crowds come down and they take it over, they don't want us to be down there. They have yellow lines down and all that. We have to stay inside the yellow line, like, you know. We're like convicts down here, you know. But we take no notice of money, but we still go ahead, like, do what we have to do. It's been done for generations and generations, and it will be done for generations and generations. They're the ones that should move, they're blocking us. So for a beautiful harbour, like, there's not a punt on the river or anything. So I suppose you can't blame them, you can't moor off a punt down here, like, with the harbour board and all that. They're taking over this place, they're taking over the camber up above, and they're taking over the railway side and the whole lot, the water's edge. They just come along, put up a sign, and you just obeying, that's it, like. No, this place is dead now, like, dead. Used to be great, like, people down here swimming up, you know, out the quay and all that. Like, they have a big gangway out there onto them boats out there, and we can't tie up alongside them, and we can't get up and down the gangway if we come in and punts or anything like that. No. They want the whole place to themselves, like, you know, which is wrong, like. I have no objection being there, like, but if they just leave the bloody mineral one, like, and that's it. Coming down, putting up signs for this, signs for that, and signs for everything. And taking over down the railway station and everything, sure.
Would you have noticed much of a change in the water quality in the harbour since the time when you were a young lad?
Oh, it did, yeah. Years ago you had it, but then again there's a bigger population here now, like. Like, no, oh God almighty, this sort of, I wouldn't go swimming, I wouldn't eat anything out of this harbour. I wouldn't eat any kind of a fish out of this harbour. If I was starving, I'd probably eat you, no, before I'd eat a fish out of that harbour, like, that. And that's being honest, like, no, it's manky, like. But then again, you had Pfizer's and net and all them places, the sores come down from Cork and everything. So there's no one fishing over here now. There's only a handful of punts. The fishermen are gone. Well, what were fishermen what that were here, like? But I worked on the tenders going out to the liners, all right, a couple of years ago, when the old liners used to come in. You might often get two in the harbour, but they used to come in here, like, into the station. You make a couple of bob, like, you know. But them days are gone now and all, like. I mean, we were really looking at Yanks then, like, you know what I mean? With these liners coming in, like, you don't know who they are. What they are. they're probably as badly off as we are, like. I think some of them are, anyway. They don't spend much here, no.
You had Sharky
and Danny Jordan. Oh, there was a rake of dockers here and all that one time. Yeah. But they're all gone. They're all gone. Like, when you look over there and we see Irish Steel gone, like, you know. That was a great boom to the town, like. If they know, well, they're making a car park out of the place over there. For what, I don't know, like. Who wants to go there in the middle of nowhere, like, park your car? Unless they put a cinema or something up there. They might make a couple of bob then. Thousands and millions for that place over there. Millions. And we're still poisoned. Poisoned from it. Yeah.
What's your best memory, Sam, of living in Cobh?
Mine? Oh. Best when you could come down here and get mackerel and what have you, like, you know. They'd be jumping on the strand and you could go swimming down here, down the park. They used to put the bodies in there, like, and people off to Lusitania. There was two brothers in there. They were fishing down off the bay there and they got lost one bad night. I didn't know them, like, but I heard tell of them, like, you know. They were the last two that I know was in there, like. But there was a lot of bodies in there, all right, like. Down through the years. But, it hasn't been used for years now, anyway, like, you know.
Yeah.
But I don't think they use them now, anyway, like, you know, they're too modern now today.
There are stories I've heard about coal being washed up along the shoreline here. Can you throw any light on those, or have you heard any of these stories yourself, Sam, over the years?
Oh, yeah, but that would be belong to them when the British were here. Yeah. You get it in Spike down on the front of Spike, the back of Harbourne, but it's gone now, like. Oh, yeah, big lumps of coal, like. Lumps of. For the old steamboats. If you dredge in the harbour, like, don't know, like, crawl for them, like, don't know what I mean, but an old trawl. You get them, like, the coal, and it's the best that you could still use it, like. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I've often used it, like. I often got it there on the Spike and by the pier. But there's only one thing then, sometimes then, like, what often happened to me, like, I get the coal. And there might be a lump of pitch in between it, like, and you wouldn't know the difference between that until you light the fire, and then you're in trouble. Oh, Jesus. Oh, that's it, no. Plenty of coal there.
What do you think is the biggest change in Cobh since the time when you were a young lad?
Yeah. My God, there is changes very big. Well, the population, for one, anyway, God, no one knows who's who. Years ago, everybody knew who was who and who was related to who. You know, nobody knows. No, and that's a fact, like, you just haven't a clue who they are. No. But, like, even the whole of Cobh, like, changed, like. I mean, you go back of the island there and the whole other buildings and houses and things. That's why all the sewer pipes are blocked up and everything, so. You know, there's too much population there, like. And.
Would you remember the Holy Ground when it was booming? Would you say, like, all the shops and, say, from here?
Oh, yeah, here. Yeah. Horley.
Oh, there used to be a pub up here as well.
There was a. I forget the name of the one that was up behind us now, but there was.
It was Mars.
There was Mars. There was a pub here. And there was a. Joanie's. And there was Marty Pluck standing up on the top of the hill, the Anchor, the Horizon. Oh, there was about 36, 37 pubs here one time.
There's shops all the way though.
And shops, yeah. Perry, Dick, Stella, what's her name? I can't think of her name now. She had a shoe shop, like. Oh, yeah, there was Mrs. Finn. Yeah, and butcher shops and everything there, like, they're all gone, Osha. Post office is gone. They're all gone. They're all gone, bear me. Ah, yeah. Oh.